in here now. Somebody better get a shout on, because you don't know what tomorrow is going to hold. Somebody pray. Glory.
There's some out there that'll fool you. They'll fool you in them sheep clothes, wolf clothes, and you know what I'm trying to say.
Listening. You are good. Hey, 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 come on, everybody. Say, you are good. Hey, yeah. Come on, everybody. You are good. Hey, 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 hey. Woo, come on. Say, you are good. Say, you are good all the time, all the time. You are good, you are good all the time, and all the time. You are good, you are good, you are good, you are good all the time. You are good, you are good. You are good. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, yeah. Hallelujah. Put your hands together now.
Me and Sister Rebby working with the kids, so we working with ages from 6 to 12, and I love my announcement. But on March the 4th, we're going to have our next rehearsal at 6 o'clock, and I'm gonna have a list so we can have people pick the kids up. So we'll be last right. minute.
There
so
you go.
Y'all help us out. Help us out.
Overall in the 1979 NBA draft by the Lakers. When he even won a championship in his rookie season and won 4 more championships. Johnson was retired in 1991 after he had said he had. Oprah Winfrey, a movie star, has her own company and have been on TV. She was born in Mississippi, 1954. She hosts her first talk show in 1977, which was called The People Are Talking. After moving to Chicago, she hosted a new talk show called AM Chicago, which changed to The Oprah Winfrey Show. Her first movie part came in 1985, The Color Purple. In 1996, she started her own magazine called O. Oprah company is called Harpo, Oprah spelled backwards. Which she is the first African-American president. Mr. Obama is our 44th president. His father was from Kenya and his mother from Kansas. President Obama was born in Hawaii on August 4, 1961. He was raised with help from his grandfather who served in Peyton's Army and his grandmother who worked her way up from. Upon graduation, he returned to Chicago to help lead a voter registration drive, teach constitution law at the University of Chicago, and remain active in his community.
Man.
President Obama's years of public service are based around his unwavering belief in the ability to unite people around a politics of purpose. The Illinois State Senate assassinate, he passed the first major ethics reform in 25 years, cut taxes for working families, and expanded health care for children.
And that when we are in worship, that moves God to glorify. We glorify God in our worship. And the more media we worship God, the more faster he gets to our problems. Now, the only people that could get a vision or those who can worship in the face of oppositions, which means you may be going through some things, but you can't see what you're going through or see a way out of it. But God, if you still praise God and worship him, he will be there to your rescue immediately because he understands your vision and your purpose. Now, as I move, there was a woman in Mark chapter 5. And this woman had an issue of blood. She said to herself, if I could just touch the hem of his garment, something will happen. because of her press toward to touch the hem of his garment. She crawled and got to Jesus and touched a piece of something that was connected to Jesus. She touched his robe, and the Bible uses the word immediately. Everything in her body that was out of order got right back in order immediately as she touched the hem of his garment. I came to tell you this morning, God's got the power to heal something in your body that's out of order, something that's out of order. God's got the power to put it right back together and in order. He just wants you to know that you are on the same or the same page as God is. That means when you come into the house of God, you want to give God all your praise. You forget about the problems that you dealt with all week long. Because when you come here, we don't come here just to sit here. We come here to magnify, to worship God so that he can fix that problem on the outside of these doors immediately, quicker than expected. It's getting ready to happen immediately. Now, in our verses, King Nebuchadnezzar in chapter 3 of Daniel, King Nebuchadnezzar builds a false god. And he begins to demonstrate the principles of overcompensation. He builds a false god that's made out of gold. He wants people to begin to worship these things because he realized that he is not Pharaoh. No, Pharaoh wanted you to worship the things that he have accomplished. But Nebuchadnezzar is not a real God. He does not have real power because he does not have control over people's body. He says, when the music plays, worship, because I really don't have the power or the authority over you. So when my music plays, I want you to bow down and to worship. He says, because I want you to obey what I have told you to do. And the music started playing, and the choir started singing, or the harp started playing. And as they were sitting there and all that were playing, there were three young men. I don't know if they were young, middle-aged, or old, but there were three men sitting in the back. As everybody began to bow down to him, three men that were sitting in the back still stood up and didn't bow down. So that made King Nebuchadnezzar, one of the ushers that was there, went back to report to him. So now as I move in verse number 6 in Daniel chapter 3, they don't take many words from it, but you know, don't take my word from it. It says, you know, here, and whosoever falleth not down and worshipeth shall the same hour, which means immediately, be cast into the midst of the fiery furnace. So here now, it is a disconnect and the exposure of faulty power coming from the line of Satan's. Satan tried to control what you do, because he done messed around and tried to use the word that he's not ordained to use or authorized to use. So he says, however, who does not bow down will immediately be thrown in the fire. Now, I'm pretty sure you know the story by now. It's about Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. Now, they'll become the main characters here. To provide a way of escape. Don't you dare cry about what you're going through. Don't you dare lose your mind about what's happening to you. Don't you dare get stressed out about your bills and what you can't pay, because God will soon open a door for you. Shout glory. Hallelujah. And now Shadrach says, I got confidence that the door is going to open. Shadrach had confidence that the door is going to open. So he said, I'm just going to praise him while I'm under fire. I don't need nobody to help me praise him, because I know that God is going to make a way of escape, because he's getting ready to open up the door. All I got to do is praise him for what he's doing right now. If I could just get through through my thoughts of disappointment. If I could just get through through my thoughts of depression. If I could just get through through my thoughts of being stressed out. Because I know, just like Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego were sitting there in the fiery furnace. They didn't go looking for a fan to cool off with. They just sat right there and started praising God because they knew that someone out there had the power to do something immediately and suddenly. He will do it. Turn to your neighbor and say, immediately. Hallelujah. 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 And when it comes time, if you find yourself alone and you can't praise God by yourself, you get yourself a partner, just like Shadrach did and Meshach did. It was three of them in there because the Bible says, well, there's two or three that are gathered in my name, there will I be in the midst. So if you don't feel like praising him by yourself, you grab you a partner and they praise God for you and you praise God for them because God can do it for them just like he can do it for you. And he can do it immediately and suddenly. Shout glory. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Now it won't take long. Immediately. It won't take long for God to do what he got to do. And my last point, in Daniel chapter 3, in my last point, I'm in the last verse of the chapter. So, you know, I had to read the whole chapter and the last verse, and it was critical for me. And it may be for you today, but as soon as they got pulled out of the fire, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, as soon as they got pulled out of the fire, the king Nebuchadnezzar promoted them. As soon as he pulled them out the fire, there was no interview process. There was no application to fill out. There was no betting on the side of who will last the longest in the fire. Immediately, they got promoted. Immediately.
Tell you the truth is in our ancient past. would like to know more about your heritage, please stop by the Cosby Educational Heritage Center in the OC Hill Neighborhood Center at 445 Bowman Street. For appointments, please call us at 419-775-8834 or 419-571-4627. And always remember, education is the key.